Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20, makes it to the 22-yard line. The Bruins, and talking with him this week, Kirk, is just interesting, their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself, and I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. Coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time where he just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome. And I'll be shocked if they can slow him down.
Brought down at the 33. Short gain by the running back, and that's a first down.
Not a huge run, but enough to move the chains, and that's all that matters.
Quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 37.
Rose on the tackle at the 37-yard line. That makes it second and six.
Perkins gets the call again. Gain of six on the draw play.
That's a gain of six on the play. Third down.
Around the 49-yard line.
To be successful, you've got to be able to come through on third down, and that's just what they did with that big run.
Runs right for a nice gain.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
From the 45-yard line, it's second down. Slings it. He's tackled at the 46, and they'll lose a yard there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
That makes it third and seven.
Here's the eighth play of the series. It out to his receiver in a hurry, and down he goes at about the 31, and a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Quick throw, almost intercepted.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? Drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
There's a strike complete. Tackle made around the 26-yard line.
With the 26-yard line. That'll bring up third and four.
And a quick throw. He's knocked out of bounds around the 21-yard line.
Well, they're living on the edge here a little bit, but, you know, they're converting when they have to.
Dumps it complete over the middle, and he's tackled around the 14-yard line.
Joseph on the tackle at the 14-yard line. That makes it second and two.
There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
False start, offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
From the 19-yard line, second down. On the ground, inside, and he carries the ball for a nice gain. Lee gets 6 yards on the carry.
That'll bring up 32.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
makes it first and goal.
Hit as he threw, and he completes it. And he's level at the five.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and goal.
They come out in a five-wide set. They try to get a head start there.
False start, offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
From the 10-yard line. Second down. Gives it to the back. He makes it to the 9. The halfback picks up a yard.
That makes it third and goal.
5 wide. To the end zone, intercepted.
Oh, boy. I bet he knew as soon as he released that football that he shouldn't have made the throw. And that's the thing. When you're under that kind of pressure, it takes away that one split second you need to scan the area so you know where it's a safe throw.
From their own 20-yard line, it's first down. Here's the give. And he's taken down at the 22-yard line. Well, player down, and his teammates obviously worried after that play. Quick pass, and they make the stop at the 21.
Number 44, at the 21-yard line. That'll make it 3rd and 9.
From their own 21-yard line, it's 3rd down. Attempted to pick up the first by running it, and they failed.
And the defensive line won that battle easily.
Adams is the deep man awaiting the return. And he's tackled at the 48-yard line. We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Inside give. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Steps up in the pocket and sacked.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
3rd down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. The Cornhuskers' running game just took a big hit. Their back went out earlier with that injury, and now they're telling us not going to be able to return today. Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. He's taken down around the 38-yard line.
First down.
Hopefully he's going to be okay.
Man left, man left.
1st and 10. Ball on the 38. Got it. And he goes down quickly.
Number 15 with the tackle at the 32-yard line. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
He gets to about the 24-yard line.
First down.
Down.
second and five.
This defense has been in this situation before. They forced a huge turnover when they were backed into their own red zone last time. They'll give it off here. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
And they'll run him again. Nice run to the left there. Lee gets about 4 yards on the play.
That brings up second and goal.
We've played one quarter. Now this one's scoreless. We're all tied up as we head into quarter number two. The Bruins saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. Up the middle for a nice game.
Game of six on the play. That makes it 3-4.
Touchdown, Bruins!
Great tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 53-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And they get nice yardage on that run. So he picks up about 5 on the option to the halfback.
Brings up second and 5.
Second down and 5. Ball on the 30-yard line. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
They got lucky on that play. That receiver was wide open, but the quarterback just missed it. That is a great play here by the corner to be able to knock that football away. Many cases, you'll see a corner actually try to knock the football away, and he'll interfere with the wide receiver. This time, he keeps his body and arms away from the receiver and still knocks it away. That's a big-time play.
Got the corner. And they push him out at about the 41. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. UCLA is up a score. Off inside. He gets hit out of bounds around the 43-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
Caught over the middle. And he is drilled at the 49-yard line.
Number 52 on the top there at the 49-yard line.
He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
And he's stopped behind the line.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
And so it's another 3rd down upcoming here. Pulls it in, 1st down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
That's good for a game of 13 yards. 1st down.
Switch. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. UCLA is up 7. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 4 yards. That brings up 2nd and goal.
UCLA! And that's his 2nd touchdown of the day.
You know, this quarterback continues to score touchdowns, and you can see how happy this makes his offensive lineman. A running quarterback and a quarterback scoring touchdowns with his legs takes a lot of pressure off the big boys up front.
He makes the PAT. The Bruins wide receiver down there on the sideline looks like he's warming up. Good to see that he might be able to get back in this game. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? That's a great tackle at the 38. From their own 38-yard line. First down. Strike to his receiver, no good.
More the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a game of 7 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 3.
3rd down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Nice run there. Decent game there on the play by the running back, and that's enough for the first.
If you can consistently get 4 or 5 yards at a pop, you know that you're going to have a functioning offense.
Here he goes. Makes it out to about the 43.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
So it's 2nd down and about 2 yards to go. Him hard to the 36-yard line. It's complete for about 7 yards and a first down.
They've done a great job on this drive with the underneath pass. The quarterback isn't forcing the ball, and you can see how effective he is.
Decent run here, right side.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. He's going to try and scramble, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Brought down around the 29-yard line. About 6 yards on that completion.
They executed the screen play well here by getting the ball to the halfback. They pick up some yards.
The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start, offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
They'll call on the field goal unit. kicks away, and it's wide right. No good. Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 34. Fires incomplete to the fullback.
Number 32 is the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and 10.
He fights forward to about the 36. The draw play gets maybe 2 yards. Nebraska will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. And this one is a beauty. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. He did a good job there to give his team decent field position. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. He's got to throw it in a hurry. And down he goes. Around the 35-yard line. Nebraska is going to have to use their second timeout of the half. We've got a second and 5. Ball on the 35-yard line. He scrambled. Fumble! Now the defense has it. The safety. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line. It was a quick 3 and out on their last possession. Throws. UCLA's going to take their first time out of the half.
Huge play for both the quarterback and receiver, but it all starts with the big fellas up front who provided the time to get the quarterback a chance to throw.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. About a 4-yard gain there on the quarterback draw. That brings up a second and goal. 3 yards for the touchdown. Touchdown, Bruins. He's been a force getting to pay dirt 3 times.
Tell you, these guys are coming out firing on all cylinders. They've really taken control of this game early.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. He laterals the ball. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 28-yard line. It's 2nd and 7. Ball on their own 28. First half comes to a close as they head to the locker rooms. UCLA's got a 3-touchdown advantage. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. UCLA's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
going deep, lays it out there.
And he's taken down at the 23.
And they were ready for the blitz that time.
Well, I tell you what, I would think twice about bringing the house like that against this offense. They handled it very well and turned it into a big game.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10.
He fights forward to about the 20.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Goes left and tackled in a hurry.
No gain on the play. That makes it 37.
Third down and 7. Ball on the 20-yard line.
And they get the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he just drilled it from long range.
Brown looks ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick.
He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 21.
They're set to go for another round.
Roger, Roger. No, check that. Go like 52 right here. I got you.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings up second and 5.
Roger, Roger.
Taken down at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. Gets to about the 44-yard line.
Third down.
He might not be able to get the pass off. They bring him down.
That's a loss of the play. That brings up fourth and 15.
The Cornhuskers lose one of their key players with that injury earlier. Still in the locker room. We don't know the severity, but unlikely that he'll play any more football this afternoon.
He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
And they make the stop
around the 41-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
He's tackled
at about the 43-yard line.
Runs it left for a decent game.
It's second and six. Ball in their own 47. Fires it out. Tackle at the 41. Over the middle to his tailback. They'll bring him down around the 42-yard line.
That'll bring up second and 11.
From the 42-yard line, it's second down. Taylor on the give, and he's tackled around the 39-yard line. The Cornhuskers running back down there on the sideline, he was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like he's ready to go. Sets up a screen, tailback's got it, knocked out of bounds at the 29. This is the eighth play of this drive. He's scrambling, brought down at about the 29-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. And he is drilled at the 23-yard line.
Fisher on the tackle at the 23-yard line. That'll bring up.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. He guns it to the left. Touchdown, and it ain't over yet. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 10-play, 69-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 21-10. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. He makes his way out to about the 35.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. First down.
Where's 52?
Has some daylight. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 5 on the play.
Hey, watch the screen. Watch the screen.
That brings up second and 5.
Watch the screen.
They bring him down in the backfield. From their own 38-yard line, third down. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And down he goes at about the 47-yard line. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. 21-10, Bruins. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it.
Andrews, the intended receiver on the play.
Second and 10. Ball on the 47.
My 52.
third down.
Right here.
There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 38.
That's good decision-making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
And that's the safety who stepped up to make that tackle.
Down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of 4 yards. That'll make it 35.
Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately.
That brings us 4th and 7.
So it's 4th down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. The kick is away. It's long enough. No good. He hooked it right. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it 2nd and 8.
From their own 37-yard line, it's 2nd down. And here's a quick throw. This one is dropped. Watch out. Oh, almost had a pick. So 4th down coming up.
And give credit to the defense there. They played very disciplined and were able to break up the pass.
Adams back deep to return. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Fires back to the tailback, but he can't bring it in.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
2nd down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 35. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands.
Perkins was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it 4th and 10.
Booming kick. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. And they got him for a loss.
Did somebody miss an assignment there? I mean, this kid came in untouched. I don't know if it's the wide receiver or maybe the tight end. Somebody's got to be able to block that corner. He's going to make plays all day.
It's 2nd down and 11 to go. Ball on their own 26. That's a great
tackle at the 25-yard line.
That was just smash-mouth, helmet-to-chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
Let's it fly. Almost intercepted.
Moore, the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up 4th and 13.
Adams, the return man. Oh, man, he took him down hard.
Return for a gain of 11 yards.
Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? They'll give it off here. He fights forward to about the 46.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
From their own 46-yard line, 2nd down. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Up the middle for a nice gain.
Gain of 4 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Slings it, and he's taken down around the 37-yard line. Nebraska just took their first timeout. From the 37-yard line, 1st down, empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, 5 wide receivers. He makes it to the 35-yard line. Nebraska is going to have to use their 2nd timeout of the half. Perkins gets another handoff. Gains his way to the 26-yard line. Nebraska's called their final timeout. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
From the 24-yard line, 2nd down. Tackled for a loss.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
That makes it 3rd and 11.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. He fights forward to about the 26. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 21-10, Bruins.
21, and the Cornhuskers.
For EA Sports 10. And Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.